Hey everybody, Jay from CJ Skate Park. Got an amazing, again, another special guest, Adam Hopkins, all the way from Vancouver. Second place in the bowl. Amazing runs. One of Canada's amazing Olympians, gonna be representing Canada, we hope.
Potentially, yeah.
If not this year, next year. But you know, you're probably one of the best bowl skaters in the world. And obviously you love it, and you're good, and your technical aspects, your speed, it's crazy. It was crazy watching it.
Thanks,
it's inspiring.
Man. Appreciate that.
And I think one of the nicest things I heard, I mean, I heard so many nice things, but you know, we have these two Japanese brothers who all month they're going, Adam Hopkins, we're doing less than Adam, we want to see Adam, we want to watch. And they just watched you, and to watch, even though you were only a couple hours with them, to watch the progression just over a couple days was amazing. I don't know if you noticed it or...
Oh yeah, for sure.
It's like...
Well, it's the thing, I feel like in Canada, a lot of people are used to skating like a basement mini ramp. That's their perception of transition skating. But as soon as you go to the West Coast and go to Oregon or Washington or California, there's a lot of round wall and pool coping and tile, which is kind of what you have in that bowl. So it's kind of foreign for some Canadians, but once you have someone in there sort of showing them direction and how to really utilize those curves in the bowl, it's not that hard to pick it up and get, you know, gain some basic skills. So it's really cool to see those kids go from just carving lines in the bowl to hitting tile, then grinding coping, then doing early grab airs, and then Haru was doing late grab airs as well. So, you know, and that's just the start of it. That's 2 days in, so.
But your approach you had, I thought was amazing. You know, one of our skaters, Richie, who was probably one of his first contests, was bowl contests, and he was having a hard time doing the 540, and you went and showed him, and he just nailed it. Like, he nailed it for his run, and that was because of you. That coaching ability and to be able to see those lines that not everybody can see.
It's funny because I was having trouble with the same trick, but watching Richie try it, I was like, oh, that's what I'm doing wrong too. So I was like, yo, like try it over here. Because what was happening is he kept spinning into the corner, which was, he's landing in a quarter pipe going the other way, so I kept spinning him out, and then he ended up, yeah, he made it third run, and then jumps out of the bowl. It's like, dude, why'd you do that? You did 540, like finish your run. He's like, I'm just happy with that, I'm done, like so honorable.
Now I learned something. This is not planned at all, but I know you're sponsored by Element, but this is pretty cool for those of people who like spice. So tell us about this. This is so cool.
So Heartbeat Hot Sauce is a company from my hometown of Thunder Bay, Ontario. It's made locally, it's sold all over the world, and when they heard about me on the Olympic trail and doing competitions, they decided to sponsor me and help me out with some travel funds and unlimited hot sauce. So I have a bunch of sample bottles that I've been handing out my travel.
I know, I saw you giving some.
Yeah.
I got one for my wife, actually.
Well, I actually had a guy come up, he saw my shirt, and he's like, Heartbeat, like the hot sauce. And I was like, yeah. And he was like, I have a ball at home, it's amazing. And he saw the logo, he already knew the stuff. But I guess it's sold all over the world already. But
it's famous, and it's amazing.
And you know, a lot of people have like beer sponsors and things like that. And I remember reading an interview years ago with, I think it was Tony Hawk, where he's talking about like Bagel Bites and McDonald's. And he was saying like, I'll never do a sponsor unless I actually use the product. And
true.
I use that stuff on my eggs every morning. Like whenever it's holidays or something, I always get a bottle because it's from my hometown. My parents have sent me a bottle, so I've been using the product for a long time. And then ended up meeting the people behind it when I was in Thunder Bay.
It's your secret hot sauce that keeps you going.
I guess so. Every morning.
What did you think of the bowl? Because I mean, look, you've skated some of the best bowls and parks in the world.
Mm-hmm.
Honestly, not putting you on the spot.
I like it. I think it's really fun. It's not really like a park design bowl. It's more of a traditional bowl, pool style bowl. Good round wall, good coping. The coping. One thing that's funny about Canada, I feel like too, is like the coping in skate parks. It's not hard to do it properly, but a lot of places it's never enough, not too much. Like the coping.
It was from Oregon.
Yeah. It's tether stud, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, it's really good. Pull block.
You know your stuff.
I'm a skate nerd.
No, it's funny because I called him up and because we want to do the best that we can, right? And I go, hey, can you give us a deal? He says, I make the best. There's no deals.
Yeah.
So we're not for profit. He looked it up. He did give us a discount, which was cool. But amazing guy, amazing story, right? That's all he does.
He's got a full, in his backyard, he has all these concrete quarter pipes with every type of pool coping that he makes is on these quarter pipes in different spots, which is really cool. But back to the bowl. The bowl's great. I love it. It's cool because the half pipe section is very tight, but in a bowl contest or in a park contest, you don't really want people half piping. So the way it's designed is it forces you not to half pipe.
Right.
So you are using round wall, shallow, hip, into the deep, out of the deep. So like the vert skaters that traditionally will go into a bowl contest and just half pipe the deep end and do the big crazy airs, it kind of forces them to skate more like park style skaters. So I feel like it's a bit more of an even playing field in that way.
I mean, it's funny, I'm nowhere near your level, obviously, but I find that because there's not a lot of sort of flat walls, you're pumping the whole friggin' time. Like, I think I lost 5 pounds last time. Yeah. Like, there is, people don't realize how much cardio is in. Like, it's insane.
I guess so. Well, if you watch James Clark, for example, like, he gets so much speed out of everything, but that man can run. Like, if you put him running down the street, just go and go and go.
He should be a marathon runner.
He could be, too. He's a... It's crazy skating. Another thing is skating Hastings. Like, we're both products of Hastings Bowl, so big, long flats, big,
huge.
Long walls.
I have done it. It's very, it's huge.
You stay on your board for a long time. So coming to something like this, we're pumping a lot, but we're used to long, drawn-out, mellow Canadian transitions. So when you get to something like this, it's like, oh, this is great. This is fast.
And you got some good height there, and you had, yeah.
It's fun. I'm looking forward to skating in the next few days, too, before I leave as well, because now that the contest and pressure's off, it's just having fun with it.
A lot of pressure.
Day by day.
Well, you know, I want to thank you for coming and helping out with some of the lessons. You've really been a mentor and inspiration to this newer generation of skaters. So I think it's great. Adam Hopkins, man, you watch for him.
Come skate the bowl.